Pombe ni bure.
You have to be very smart. Because pombe huku ni bure kwa madem.
Yes. Ni mtali ndio mna bocha ndio mna struggle.
Don't worry, it's raining in Dubai. It's so different when it's sunny.
Alcoholic. So guys, welcome back to Oku Dubai. We are here to show you the best of the best, the unscripted, the realistic, and everything you can mention. So now let's head down to see what we are here to show you. Benzi.
Hey mom.
Hey, how are you feeling?
Mimi kama kawa, niko fit.
Eh?
Chonjo.
Yes.
Tusemeaje sasa?
So now we are heading to that location yenye tumeambiwa sisi tunataka kwenda kuonyesha mazuri ya Dubai, and you know, as usual to go kwa so informative. So ningependa tu kujua, yani, what are your experiences in alcohol? As in, pombe ni mbaya? Me, by the way, question, the reason why I'm asking ni juu nimeget so many people ask me, because you know we are the wine couple, naona logo pale mcheza kama wewe Nyaga Wines,
Chonjo
mcheza kama wewe,
shoes ziko kwa bei.
Yes.
Tisho
fiti. Wine lovers.
Ukitaka ikiwa na logo, hii ni logo yangu. Ukitaka kaa ina logo pia ni sawa.
Yes.
Naweza kukuwekea wine.
Eish. Unataka. Any message that you want
any
on your shirt,
that
yes. Unataka kama wewe.
Bora tu unauliza Nyaga Wines underscore 101, yeah.
So what do you think? Do people mistake you for being a drunkard just because you are a wine expert? Una perspective gani na pombe, yani? As in, the best question that I can ask. Pombe ni mzuri ama ni mbaya ama, what can you say to the people?
Hiyo swali, kuna vile jitu inajikontradict. Pombe
yes.
ni mbaya ama pombe ni mzuri? Me, from my personal experience, there's a way pombe naeza kuwa mbaya,
mm-hmm.
pia there's a way pombe naeza kuwa mzuri. I mean, not mzuri, pombe it depends how you are taking it. Your intake, is it intoxicated? Or is it, maybe kama mtu kama mimi, I sell wine, I'm a wine sommelier,
mm-hmm.
so for me, it's my job to sell alcohol, but mm-hmm. I also observe some of the rules and the regulations when you're serving alcohol, because siwezi uzia mtu alewe, unaona kuna ile limit ndio ube, wenyewe huu siwezi muzia pombe tena.
Kama kuna pesa,
siwezi.
Like if they are rich and they have money.
Kama uko na pesa, mimi nitakwambia tu, of course through proper communication, siwezi uzia huu mtu pombe juu amelewa, unaona, because your health comes first, yeah, and drinking responsibly, hiyo ndio ina matter. Ama
quick one, does this apply in Kenya ama tu bado ni Dubai peke yake? Because we are representing Oku Dubai as Kenyan couples, but
so,
what you're saying in apply in both countries ama tu Oku Dubai?
Nishauza pombe Kenya, because I used to sell kwa pub and everything. I never had experience because nilikuwa tu naanzia, si ndio? But mimi change sana nakuambia experience yangu na pombe, kuuza pombe na ku, you know, kuuza watu pombe ni huko Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
That's where like the real deal iko.
Yeah.
Mali, like naweza sema I experienced it. Na get?
Yeah.
And there are a few things that you know, I don't think Kenya they take it serious like Dubai wanaitake, unaona?
Mm-hmm.
Kunywa pombe Dubai, actually unajua Kenya wengi wanasema na Kenya, I mean Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
Dubai hakuna pombe.
Mm-hmm.
Na get?
Yeah.
But actually I think, from my opinion, Dubai iko na pombe mingi
kuliko Kenya. Yes.
You know that.
Na ingine hata ni ya bure.
Na kwanza wewe kama wewe ni dem Dubai.
Pombe ni bure.
You have to be very smart.
Yes.
Because pombe huku ni bure kwa madem.
Yes. Ni mtali ndio mna bocha ndio mna struggle.
Vijana lazima tuhasu. Vijana na pombe lazima uhasu. Ukitaka kunywa pombe lazima uwe na pesa. Ama vipi? So swali yako juu nimesahau kidogo ilikuwa nini?
Unasema pombe ni mzuri ama ni mbaya?
Pombe nikiongelelea kidubai, pombe inaweza kuwa mzuri na inaweza kuwa mbaya. In good way inaweza kuwa because it's regulated. Kukunywa pombe Dubai in a good way if kama una consume ukiwa kwa hao ukiwa maybe na mabeste, there are things you need to follow like rules and regulations that you make ziko authorized na gava ya Dubai. Na kama unakunywa pombe like ikiwa mingi juu pombe huko ni mingi, pia it can be harmful to your work, it can be harmful to your picture, you know, how people see you, it can be harmful na mambo na job, una get it? Na pia you can do things that you regret tomorrow. Unajua tu pombe, unajua mimi I'm not an advisor of alcohol people,
yeah,
alcoholic people, but as you all know, kwa kweli pombe si nzuri ukikunywa vibaya, but if you drink responsibly, pombe inaanza kuwa it's that fun, una get it? Because I don't wanna say pombe ni nzuri. Mine is not to advocate pombe ni mzuri. Actually, yeah, kama unaweza acha na pombe ni vizu.
Yeah.
But pia unajua sawa kama sisi tunauza pombe tuwezi sema achaneni na pombe.
Hustle inaisha hivyo.
Sasa tutafanyaje kazi bwana? Hey, hata wanachomanga
kazi. Hey, na saa hii unajinenda wapi?
Saa hii?
Eh.
Sijui niwaambie.
Hapana, tuonyeshe.
Niambie saa hii.
Tuonyeshe.
Acha tu nionyeshe alafu nitaambia more information.
Action is better than words.
About the reason why tunaongelea history ya pombe, unaona? It will come hand in hand, huh?
Yes.
Ina itango hivyo?
Yes.
Inakuja. So, chill out, wait, and you'll see what you're going to talk about, huh?
Okay, sawa sawa basi.
Twende.
We are on the way, by the way, guys, as you can see. Tuko njiani. Tunaenda. So, that's Dubai Mall for you. Tunapitia Dubai Mall. Tukielekea kwenye tunaenda. So, tume prefer guys kuchukua nini taxi instead. It's easier and it's convenient for us. Tungeonyesha venye unafaa kwenda kwa public transport and everything, but since we have a lot to do to our day to day, maybe tumechukua tu taxi. So, tune my guys tuonyeshe.
What happened is 3 months ago. I didn't have the license, you know, to do anything, you know. So I decided to take this license, and you can only take it from, two main official retailers in Dubai. One is African Eastern, the other one is MMI, as you can see, mine I took it in MMI, the one in Singapore. So I went there and applied for alcohol license. Actually, they have sent me a message that I can go for it, yeah? Don't worry, it's raining in Dubai. So it rains when it's sunny. So,
oh my god.
So yeah, that's it. We are here to pick up the license, yeah?
Okay. So how are you feeling that you're coming to pick up a license? Why come and apply for a license? For what? You can drink, right?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
The rain is too much.
That's
I think here it's okay. So basically what you have to do is if you want to drink alcohol, only to drink alcohol, to make sure that it's legal. I know some people they drink without a license, some people they don't even understand about license, but it's advisable when you are in Dubai, if you're a tourist, that or if you are arrested here, make sure that you know you have a license. Make sure that you have a license. What happens is when you're in Dubai, you need to make sure that you want to consume alcohol anyway. As a resident or as a tourist, you need to make sure you have a license. Make a license from the two retailers that I've said, MMI and African Eastern. And once you have this license, I'm going to tell you all about it, how to apply it. It's legal for you to drink up anywhere, not just in public, not only on public, in the restaurants. You can drink up going at home. And when maybe you meet authority, maybe the police, and maybe they find you that you're drinking up, at least you have something to show them that I'm regularly drinking in Dubai. Yes?
Okay, that's amazing. So right now, like we were talking about earlier, that if alcohol is good, it's not good. You mentioned that it could be like there are pros and cons when it comes to alcohol. So right now we are gonna go and take your license. Does it mean that you can just consume alcohol anywhere in Dubai?
No, actually, you cannot just drink alcohol anywhere. No, there are too many things like that can make you get jailed in Dubai. And one of those things is alcohol. So when you drink alcohol, you need to make sure that it's not intoxicated. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Second thing, you need to make sure that you are of age. The age of drinking, the restricted age of drinking in Dubai is from above 21 years. Huh?
Yeah.
Right? So if you are from Kenya, come from Kenya, if you want to put your home in Dubai, maybe you want to put your vacation, make sure that you are not going to put your name in Dubai, maybe you are from 18, because that's the age to drink in Kenya scale. Mm-hmm. Make sure you have 21 years to be able to consume alcohol in Dubai. Again, otherwise, it might lead to get jailed, you know, potential imprisonment, again, which are things you can avoid, yeah.
Okay, that's interesting. So, right now you're going to get your license. Bear with us at Transport Metro Nandani, but we'll show you the license. Once we are outside, okay, guys, so we love you. Let's go inside. Hey, Buddha boss, even though I'm feeling a license, alcoholic.
Saying me ndio kupata hizi e document e license, first you need to be a resident, okay, and if you are a resident you need to have passport and your valid visa if you are a resident, okay. That means this day is the ID consists of your visa, yes, And if you're a tourist and you want to drink alcohol, you can just go to any retail shop that is officially assigned that duty, go with your passport and go with your tourist visa. Okay. Second thing, make sure you are non-Muslim, because here they don't give non-Muslim license. Okay. If you are a non-Muslim resident, if you are a non-Muslim tourist, you can be able to get the license. The other thing is, there is age restriction. They cannot give you a license if you are not 21 and above, because they restricted age to get a license in Dubai. For anyone, you must be 21 and above. Less than that, you are Kenya, unajua sisi, our restricted ages to drink ni 18, but uko Dubai ni 21, so you need to make sure you are of age. The other thing, I'll go through like consequences zenye, kama una hizi vitu, what you can go through. There are so many things you can go through. Now, huu wacha ni waeremishe, hii ni Dubai. Hii Dubai kama una vitu zingine, utajipata kwa muhadhara. Na muhadhara ya kwanza kama una license, muhadhara ya kwanza utaendea ni utashikwa. Ukishikwa na polisi, so there's potential case of imprisonment. Kitu ya pili, there is what we call public shaming. Sasa zingine unasikianga wa Kenya walishikwa wakikunywa, unaona wanaeko kwa gazeti ya Dubai. The other thing ni deportation. Ukipatikana uko na pombe ama unakunywa pombe, una deportiwa mara moja tu. Unaona? Unarudishwa Kenya kama unakunywa. The other thing I think ni hii inaweza fanya ukose, ulose job yako. Unaona? Your profession na social people around you, they might mistake you as a drunkard, which is not good. Na si kusema pombe ni mbaya ama ni nzuri, I'm in the middle because I sell alcohol, I'm a wine sommelier. So drinking alcohol for me is not a bad thing. But also, if you drink it irresponsibly, it's a bad thing for me. So it depends how you drink it, okay? I think nimewambia what is most important since tuko Dubai. I think these are the things, kama unakuja Dubai, kama uko ready huko Dubai na una hii information, these are things you need to know. Since wa Kenya sisi ni watu watamunye sobana. Kanairo inafanyanga tu tukunywa. Na ndio hiyo, mimi pia pombe napenda ba. Eh? Ama vipi? Wewe wife unapenda pombe?
My friends, my guys, I also have my license.
Yeah. Yeah, you're going to license?
Yes, it's here. My license is here.
Yeah.
And I know some people would think that I don't have a license because my hubby is on a license.
Mm-hmm.
But having a license is for 50 as a person.
Mm-hmm.
And kids come up, for example, and in that environment that you are in, people are not having any license. Being in the house, for example, I'm in a party somewhere and it's a home, it's a villa, it's a penthouse, and you're the only one with a license, you can save out of there,
mm-hmm.
so that are there. So normally it's just to keep you safe because you know you're in a different country. Na pia uko place in a city home, you know. Come uko home, you can get away with that situation, but come uko country wenyewe, it's very hard. Take it easy.
Mimi nakusikiliza bana. Na unajua pia kuna ile kitu ingine inakuanga, you know. Imagine umeenda out na majamaa, mmemba maybe kwa mtu hao.
Yes.
Na hamna pombe, lakini
yes.
Kuna MMA shop hapo. Imagine hamwezi pata pombe.
Kama una
hii license huwezi pata pombe. Unaona?
They ask people license and they ask people the ID.
Mm-hmm.
So they want to see your age before they send it to you. And they want to see if you have a license.
Mm-hmm.
But if there are places you can go out of Dubai that you can get from this, one of the license and one of the license, it might depend. But to me, I'll always say, if you're in a normal land, like if you're in a land that is not in your country, it's good to have safety. But it's good to know, out of the 90% of who have papers and blah, 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 you'll be one of them. Out of the 10% in your own people in your street, deportation, and after Kenya, and after Kenya, because kupata mtu amelewa vibaya, alibebwa akapelekwa Kenya kupotea because you're misbehaving, you are pombe. So the aim of this video is to just educate you and tell you it's good to have papers with you, come up with licenses, if it's driving, you drive with a license,
you just don't drive a car because Kenya babako alikupa gari kwenda hivi mara hodi unarudi. No, here you have a license. They might not catch you that time, but they eventually will catch you. So it's better to be safe than to just be there.
Hii wanaitanga the city of order.
Yeah, this place, the rules and the law that is here, it's very strict.
It must be respected.
So, you live within what they want you to live as. Like, for example, rules zao lazima uzifuate. Kama ni traffic light rules, lazima uzifuate. Hawezi kuwa kama ni red line. Hawezi kuwa kama hakuna nini. So, you need to have all these things figured out. Otherwise, utajipata.
Hebu iseme vizuri. Otherwise,
pato kuna mashida. Otherwise, you know, so that's it for us guys. So, let's just
make it to tunaweza ongeza majama. We are working so hard.
Yeah.
At least huko Dubai is a good channel where you get the unscripted like it is the raw.
Evo
to
Evo to.
So the least you can do for us, yeah, our fans, with so much love, subscribe to,
yes, and
share.
The wine couple, naweza kutoka kuchukua license bila kamuweso.
Tumenunua wine.
We are the wine couple. We teach you more about wine.
So,
we show you
hapo
nawaambia,
it's time to wind down.
It's time to wind down. So let us go home and wind down and relax and have a glass of wine responsibly. As we celebrate having life and things. So guys, don't forget to like, subscribe. And we'll update you anything about Oku Dubai. And then, you know, as it is, let us know if you want us to bring you anything that you want to know in Dubai. Uku Dubai, Monta Kujua, Tuambi at Top Letter. As for that, this is Oku Dubai. We love you. It's been real. Bye-bye.